Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Dolls. Returning to the custom series of Persona 5, this time is the turn of Futaba Sakura, aka Oracle, the hacker and the seventh member of the Phantom Tits. Also, my favorite female character from the Persona series. What's made her more special by making this video since I starred in the series. And to make it more special, surprise surprise, is a video collab. This collaboration I do together with Dolly Mixters. We both did our own representation of the character. She did Futaba in her version in the real world, and of course I do my version with her Phantom Thief outfit. Wow, look at that beauty, those details are crazy. Go and subscribe to her channel and give her a lot of love. And well, going back to the video, I shared the concept art of the character on my Instagram, since I always do them to better study the details. And without further ado, let's get started. For the base, I will use a Lizzie Hearts doll from Ever After High, because the size is perfect for the character, since Futaba is a very short person in height. Here you can compare it with the body of another doll next to it. And thanks to Queen Sharoto to giving me the suggestion in the coming box. And with my base doll, I will begin to remove the hair from her head. As in all my costumes, I prepare yarn so that it can look like hair. Futaba has a long, beautiful orange hair, and since yarn tends to be shortened while preparing, I'll try to make the width as long as I can without getting too much the hair from the glue, staying at this length as you can see. With the wets preparing, I will begin to glue them directly to the wig cap. As it is in the back, it is the length that the hair will have at the end of this process. In this part, I will glue the hair where the line on her bangs is. And I will cut it to have it ready and not get lost later. And I continue to glue more hair. Seriously, working with this hair fiber is 100 times better than working with Kanekalon fiber, as I have already mentioned in the video of Queen. Very well, with that ready, I will start to do her hairstyle with the help of a wet brush and glue mixed with water. You know me, I don't like the hair lose its shape. If it needs to be like a helmet, que así sea. And this is how Futaba hair looks with every detail you see, including her raised hair. The best thing about working with yarn is that the hairstyle is more natural. For her mask, I will do the same process that I did with Yusuke and Nan, using masking tape with marker lines to already have a guide. In order to put the epoxy on top, trying to not use too much, since this material is heavy if used in excess. And I already have the shape ready. With the help of this, I have no idea what it is, but it looks like a kitchen tool, I will make the circle where her crystals will be. And with the help of my tools, I'll do more details. With the clay already hardening, I sculpt the detail where her ears are. And now that I see it, they look a bit like a pair of headphones. The mask is already dry. Now I will begin to detail to make it look more like a piercer. As you can see here, I glue Craftfoam around the circle to get that detail of the lenses. And then I cut the remaining pieces. Staying this way. And I also use Craftfoam to do this part. And I reinforce it all with Apoxie to make it blend. And with the shape of the mask already finished, I will paint it with black paint mixed with blue. Staying this way. Okay, the crystals were made of plastic packaging and I have colored them several times with paint and water to get transparency. To attach them to the mask, I glued them using epoxy glue, since super glue leaves marks when a piece or whatever is glued. Very well, with a tweezer, I will very carefully put the piece. Oh, Dios mío, I did it! And it was the first try! Now I glue the other crystal. To finish with the mask, I will protect all with a layer of Ultraglass mixed with a lot of water. And another layer on the crystals, this time with no water for more shine. And we have the mask of Oracle finished. The best thing about this is that it doesn't need an elastic to hold it to the doll face. For the outfit, I will use this cotton fabric that you see here. It is also perfect because it tends to stretch. The pieces are already cut, which means that I will join them with the needle and thread. Well, I already saw the top part, and off camera I saw the neck piece. And so it will be seen on the body of the doll. It seems that I will have to glue the neck piece on her chin when I finish with everything. I also add some snaps so that it can be closed without any problem. With the hair strainer, I will stretch it a little more. Very well, with a Posca marker, I draw the lines of the lights that surround her outfit. Also off camera, I made her pants with pockets included. Okay, now I will start decorating with paint. For the light lines, I will paint them with a glow-in-the-dark paint with a little neon green and yellow. I will do it carefully and with patience, since this paint is kind of transparent and I must pass it several times. Thus leaving her top part, which personally reminds me a little of the Tron movie. I record this shot at night so that you could see the effect of this paint in the dark. And for more details, I will paint lines around her pockets. Since Futaba does not wear heels, for her shoes I will use these Monster High Boy shoes, which I was cutting and completely modifying with more epoxy, to make them resemble the ones she has. Also, with the same clay, I made her elbow and knee protectors decorated with Craftfoam around. With that, I will paint them with metallic paint, give it dry brush touches with black. Going back to the shoes, I will give them a good layer of white as a base. Giving it several layers of neon green at the end. Giving me this result. But I give it a coat of matte varnish because this paint is very sticky to the touch. Much better. So that the feet enter without any problem, I will position them in the following way. I will mark the area where I will cut them, passing them a hot saw to separate them from the body. I will also position the fingers so that they look flat. With the help of a drill, I will make holes in them so that it can put a piece of wire at the end. I will secure them with super glue to be able to fill them with more epoxy. And I finished painting them with the same skin tone of the doll. I think it doesn't look like the same color. Whatever, it won't be seen in the end. Going back to the outfit, for the foot pieces, I will use this stocking fabric, as I feel like in the original outfit is in the same way. Looking like this on the doll's body. Now I can put the shoes on her feet. To secure these pieces, I will glue them with silicone directly. With Craftfoam, I made her belt with painting off camera. I just had to glue them directly to the pants and the outfit is ready. And with that, it's time to finally move on to my favorite part, the repaint. As always, I start to remove the factory paint with 100% acetone. To then begin to draw the lines of the face. Futaba has eyes a little more round than the rest of the girls, and I do my best to be able to get that shape, and not make the same mistake that I did in the video of Makoto. I think it did work out this time, which means that I can keep drawing. I'm really excited to do Futaba. As I mentioned, she's my favorite in the girl group. I literally feel like she's the friend an otaku needs. Well, back to the video, now I use a white pencil to fill the whole eye. I try not to go over so many layers of this color since the eyes are not completely white. For the base of the pupil color, I use a dark red pencil. Then I add some color to her lids and cheeks with soft pastel. With the baselines done, I can fill her eyelashes with the black pencil. I try to do it delicate as possible because the tip of these pencils always break easily, and that is very stressful. Now with a purple pencil, I will give more color to her pupil with her respective eye tone, and then give her shadows around. And with the white pencil, I will lighten them a little more. I finished with the pencil, it's time to use the paint, as always, only in the part that I want to stand out most. Now I put white paint on her mouth for the line of the teeth. Oh, and I don't want to forget the sparkle on her eyes. To later protect the work with a layer of Ultraglass on the eyes and a little on her lips. And here we have Futaba's face ready. He looks so kawaii! Now, let's see what she looks like with her hair on. ¡Qué hermosa, Dios mío! For her gloves, I first give them a coat of white paint and then paint them with the same neon green that I used on her shoes. And for the upper part, I made this with this gray fabric that I glued directly to her hands. Well, obviously, I couldn't forget to make her glasses. In one of my Instagram stories, I asked for suggestions to make props. And well, these are the ones I choose. Her laptop. A tablet I invented for her. And of course, I made this. The doll helmet that she wore in the game. Yeah, it's kinda creepy. Since Futaba is the only member of the team without weapons due to be a support character, I couldn't leave her empty-handed. So, I made her a doll stand inspired by her persona, Necronomicon. All the details you see here are painted by him, and the best thing about this is can be removed and put on, thanks to some magnets that I put on it. The tentacles can be bent without any complications. And it can be even turned without falling. If you want to see how I did it, I also made a separate video of the entire process. And without more thing to say, Oracle is ready.
Supports on the way!
Customizing this character seriously was a real pleasure, especially because of how her hairstyle turned out and her mask too. Oh God. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like what you saw, subscribe to my channel to see more content like this. Follow me on Instagram to see previews of upcoming videos and remember to check Dolly Mitster's Futaba version. Our next Phantom tip to come is Noir. My name is Eric and I will see you next time. Bye!